الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. أما بعد أحبتي في الله, I thought it would be مناسب or useful for us during this holy month of Ramadan to, I want to study actually many things related to the heart and related to seeking forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and related to those things which are going to help our iman and help us to adhere to the book of Allah and the sunnah, the message of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the madhab of the salaf. And how is it that, what's the relationship between seeking forgiveness and the madhab of the salaf? Because that is the madhab of the salaf. And that if we seek forgiveness and we seek to draw nearer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and seek to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala often, this makes your Islam real and practical. And that's why some of the muhaddithin, you know, spoke about, you know, when they were studying and memorizing a hadith, that it was like they were with the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because it makes it practical. It makes it, it is beyond the theory. When you study your Islam and you seek ilm al-nafi, a beneficial knowledge, this is making it practical. It makes it real. Otherwise, you can see how people who don't study at all and don't get many reminders, how they can go astray easily, and some leave the deen, especially those who are who embraced Islam and then they didn't do anything for their spiritual growth. So it's very important, talib al-ilm faridatun ala kulli muslim wa muslima. Seeking knowledge is an obligation on every Muslim man and female. So it's very, very important, habati fillah, to atlab al-ilm. And with that being said, I thought it would be beneficial. We're going to just do this in sittings. Just whenever I get a chance, I'm just going to sit down and we're going to try to get through this fantastic translated lecture of our Sheikh, Sheikh Abdul Razak ibn Abdul Mahsin al-Abbad, hafidhahullah ta'ala, one of our mashayikh in Medina. And it's called The Most Excellent Manner of Seeking Forgiveness. And may Allah bless us and forgive us and forgive the translator and forgive the Sheikh and bless us all with ilm al-nafi, rizqin tayyib, wa amalan mutaqabbilan. The Sheikh began, he said, all praise is due to Allah, we praise Him. We seek His aid, we ask for His forgiveness, and we repent to Him. We seek Allah's refuge from the evils of ourselves and the evil consequences of our actions. Whosoever Allah guides, then none can misguide him. And whomsoever Allah misguides, then none can guide him. I testify that none has the right to be worshipped except Allah alone, having no partner. And I testify that Muhammad is His slave and His messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. May Allah extol and send blessings of peace upon him, upon His true followers, and upon all His companions to proceed. My noble brothers, this lecture upon the topic of seeking al-istighfar, asking for forgiveness for one's sins, deals with one of the most important topics to which the Muslim should give attention to in his life and for which he should have the utmost concern. Including in it is the explanation of a tremendous way of seeking forgiveness from amongst the various forms of seeking forgiveness that can occur in the Sunnah of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. We ask Allah that it should be beneficial to us and a blessing for us. There are many texts to be found in the Book of Allah, the Majestic and Most High, and in the Sunnah of His Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam, that encourage one to seek forgiveness. Text commanding it, showing its excellence, showing the excellence of its people and of those who are constant in it. In fact, there are so many of these texts that it would be very difficult to enumerate them. From them is the saying of Allah, the perfect and the high, most high. I'm obviously being called by a very important visitor, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala preserve us in them and guide us in them. And so anyhow, we're going to try to gain benefit from this, and as a reminder of seeking forgiveness during this holy month of Ramadan, and we ask of Allah the Almighty to accept our good and blessings with tawfiq to benefit from this great treatise of our Shaykh, wa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad.